scalability. These are the advantages. There's three of them. There's going to be three disadvantages. Scalability. Business brands can often scale more easily as they are not tied to an individual. This scalability is advantageous for growth and expansion. And just think of whatever brand, think of Nike, think of almost any company that's tied to a CEO. Think about Apple. Think about Facebook. You get the point. I'm assuming you do. Second advantage, team collaboration. Business brands can involve a team, allowing for collaboration and shared responsibilities. This can contribute to a diverse range of skills and expertise. Now, when I see team collaboration, when you have a personal brand, you want to think like a business brand. Because in order to grow that personal brand, and I'm kind of going on a tangent a little bit, to grow that personal brand, you want to have a team. You want to have a team. You don't want to be the one. Now, some people may like getting behind the microphone and editing the podcast and editing the video. I don't want to do that. Okay. I do it, but I don't want to do it. Time. It takes time to do these things. This can contribute to a diverse range of skills and expertise. The team collaboration thing is the last thing there. Team collaboration is great. Just having a team is awesome. Another advantage of having a business brand, the asset value. A well-established business brand can become a valuable asset separate from individuals involved. It can be bought, sold, or passed on to successors. Your personal brand can't. But that's an advantage of having a business brand. You can sell off that company. The disadvantage is it's impersonal, obviously. Business brands can sometimes feel impersonal, lacking the human touch that personal brands often provide. This may make it challenging to establish a deep emotional connection with the audience. And that's self-explanatory. Risk distribution is a disadvantage as well. While a business brand can distribute risk among a team, it may also face challenges if there is a lack of consistency in the brand's reputation and messaging. Messaging is the key in whatever offer that you're making in terms of your brand. You hear me preach consistency a lot, but risk distribution. So impersonal is a disadvantage of the business brand, it being impersonal. Risk distribution, initial recognition is the third. It can take time for a business brand to gain recognition and trust, especially in competitive markets. And that's kind of self-explanatory as well. It's going to take time. It's going to take time to build a business brand. It's going to take time to build any brand, personal brand as well. But it's going to make time. And